published 0708 Eastern Standard Time, 6 November 2017 updated 0846 Eastern Standard Time, 6 November 2017 Ruben Loftus-Cheek assure his decision to leave Chelsea on loan for Crystal Palace has paid dividends with his call into the England squad. There has been little to celebrate at Palace so far this season, with only one win from the first 11 Premier League games. Frank de Boer, the manager who signed Loftus-Cheek, has been dismissed, and niggling injuries disrupted his start to the season, but the 21-year-old midfielder is back in the team under Roy Hodgson. Ruben Loftus-Cheek number 8 is now a regular for Crystal Palace under Roy Hodgson. The 21-year-old midfielder played in Sunday's 10 defeat by Tottenham at Wembley. Loftus-Cheek, pictured in Under 21's duty during Euro 2017, has been called up for England's friendlies against Brazil and Germany during the international break, has started 7 games, and been rewarded with a call from Gareth Southgate for the friendlies against Germany and Brazil, both at Wembley Stadium. "That's why I came away from Chelsea, to get game time," said Loftus-Cheek. "That is the most important thing for me at the moment. Experience, fitness, just getting used to playing in the Premier League week in, week out. That's what I am getting. It's been a difficult start for me, 2 games and then an injury, which I guess is a result of not playing for so long in the first place. This period is a transformation period for me. Just getting my body used to it and kicking on." Loftus-Cheek reports for duty with the England senior team for the first time, where he hopes to revive his successful partnership with Southgate, having won the Thailand Under 21 tournament together in the summer of 2016. "I've worked with Gareth for 3 years in the under 21s, and he's a really good manager," said Loftus-Cheek. "I'm looking forward to working with him. We've won tournaments together, me and him and Steve Holland. He's very good with people, players, and he treats everyone the same. What you see is what you get with him. He also demands standards in training, and that is why I think he does so well." The Chelsea Academy graduate had struggled to break into their starting side since 2014. Loftus-Cheek was at home when the England call came and caught him by surprise. "I was like, what's going on here?" he said. "It was a really good moment for me and my family, but you cannot linger on it for too long. I have got to work hard and knuckle down. I am very happy, but at the same time I have still got to work hard. I hope to play, but we'll see what happens. I'm a newcomer, so I am not expecting anything. All I can do is train well and see what happens. Hopefully I can do well." Loftus-Cheek, who has played regularly for England through the youth ranks, had an early glimpse of Wembley as he played 90 minutes in the Palace midfield as they were beaten 10 by Tottenham on Sunday. The Eagles' Loney scored his first goal for England's under-21s against Denmark back in March. "It was hard to take," said Loftus-Cheek. "We knew Tottenham were going to have most of the possession and we would have to defend hard, and we did that for a long period of the game. There are positives to take. Our confidence is building, and we're definitely improving. We have a good chance of getting some points in that period after the international break. We take it game by game. That is the best way to do it and look to improve." Palace have a run of 8 games before Christmas against teams outside the Premier League's Big Six, which will define their chances of escaping the drop. They are at home against Everton, Stoke, Bournemouth, and Watford, with away games at Brighton, West Brom, Leicester, and Swansea. By the time they go to Arsenal on December 28, Hodgson will have a good idea of his survival chances.